mid-14th century, Europe faced an unprecedented catastrophe. The Black Death, one of the deadliest pandemics in human history, swept across the continent, leaving death and devastation in its wake. The timeline of this tragedy begins in the early 1330s. The plague likely originated in China, with significant outbreaks occurring between 1331 and 1334. These outbreaks killed many and contributed to the fall of the Mongol Yuan dynasty. By the 1340s, the plague had spread to Central Asia, impacting regions such as Samarkand and Tashkent. In 1346, it traveled along trade routes, particularly the Silk Road, reaching trading posts on the Black Sea. In October 1347, the Black Death arrived in Europe via trading ships. Ships carrying goods and infected individuals docked at the Sicilian port of Messina. From there, the plague spread quickly through Italy, including the cities of Genoa and Venice. The plague's rapid spread was facilitated by fleas and rats. Infected fleas would bite rats, transferring the bacterium Yersinia pestis, which then spread among the rat population. When infected rats died, the fleas would seek new hosts, including humans, thus spreading the disease further. The Black Death struck with terrifying speed and lethality. Victims experienced fever, chills, vomiting, and the appearance of painful buboes, swollen lymph nodes, typically in the groin, armpits, or neck. The disease came in three forms: bubonic, septicemic, and pneumonic. Bubonic, the most common form, characterized by swollen lymph nodes, buboes. It spread through flea bites and contact with contaminated fluids. Septicemic, a less common but highly lethal form that spread through the bloodstream, leading to severe sepsis and tissue death. Pneumonic, the most deadly form, which affected the lungs and spread through airborne droplets, allowing for rapid person-to-person transmission. The plague spread along trade routes and through densely populated urban centers, killing millions. In 1348, the plague continued its rapid spread across Europe. Early in the year, it reached Marseille in France and spread to Spain. By spring, it had spread to Paris and the southern part of France. That summer, the plague reached England, with the first recorded cases in Dorset, then Bristol and London. It also reached Germany and the Scandinavian countries. The death toll was staggering. It is estimated that the Black Death killed between 25% and 50% of Europe's population, with some areas experiencing even higher mortality rates. The societal impact was profound. Entire communities were wiped out, and the sheer scale of death caused widespread panic and chaos. Traditional social structures crumbled, labor shortages ensued, and the economic system was severely disrupted. The plague also sparked a wave of piety and superstition, as people sought explanations for the catastrophe. In 1349, the plague continued to ravage Europe, reaching Ireland and Scotland. The population of many cities was decimated, with mortality rates reaching up to 50%. In a world unprepared for such a calamity, people turned to both science and religion for answers. Medieval doctors, known as plague doctors, wore long-beaked masks filled with aromatic herbs, believing they filtered out the miasma or bad air thought to cause the disease. Treatments included bloodletting, lancing buboes, and herbal concoctions from plants like wormwood and rosemary. Despite their efforts, these methods often proved ineffective or harmful. Religious leaders played a crucial role, organizing public processions, prayers, and penance rituals in hopes of divine intervention. Flagellants, who publicly whipped themselves to atone for sins, believed their actions could appease God's wrath. Churches were filled with the desperate cries of those seeking salvation, while pilgrimages to holy sites increased. As understanding of contagion improved, authorities began implementing quarantine measures. Ships arriving in port cities were required to anchor offshore for 40 days to ensure they were free of disease. Infected households were isolated and city gates guarded to prevent the spread. Mass graves were dug to accommodate the overwhelming number of corpses, with bodies often buried en masse, adding to the psychological trauma of survivors. These efforts, though imperfect, laid the groundwork for future public health measures. The Black Death left an indelible mark on Europe, reshaping its social, economic, and cultural landscape. Labor became more valuable, leading to improved wages and working conditions for peasants and laborers, which weakened the feudal system and allowed for greater social mobility. The church's authority was challenged, as it failed to provide answers or protection against the plague, fostering a rise in secular thinking and laying the groundwork for the Renaissance. Between 1351 and 1353, the plague continued to affect Eastern Europe and parts of Russia, while subsiding in most of Western Europe by 1352. Though the epidemic phase ended in many parts of Europe by 1353, sporadic outbreaks persisted in isolated regions until 1356. Despite the continued presence of the plague, the epidemic's aftermath spurred significant social, economic, and cultural transformations that paved the way for the modern era. Thank you for joining me in exploring the grim yet fascinating story of the Black Death. Understanding this dark chapter in history helps us appreciate the resilience and adaptability of human societies in the face of unimaginable adversity. Until next time, when we delve into another pivotal moment in history.